As you may already know, we recently released the Express App Framework, or XAF's User Authentication and Group Authorization API. This API supports both Entity Framework and the Express Persistent Objects, XPO, our ORM. A link to download the API is in the description. Getting application security right, security that is safe, fast, up-to-date, flexible, and database agnostic, is complicated. Pre-built middleware libraries like ASP.NET Core Identity or Identity Server can be difficult to configure or offer unnecessary functionality. Our User Authentication and Group Authorization API for .NET allows you to integrate a proven database agnostic security subsystem in the shortest possible time. If your Entity Framework core-based .NET app includes login/logout forms and requires security-related functionality, XAF's User Authentication and Group Authorization API is an easy-to-use alternative to custom app security logic. From WinForms and WPF to .NET Server technologies like ASP.NET Core MVC, Web API, OData, Blazor, XAF Security System is the perfect choice for the enterprise. I'll include a link in this video's description for those interested in more information on XAF's User Authentication and Group Authorization API. In this video, I'll show you how to add required DevExpress and Microsoft NuGet packages, define your EF core data model, and create a database with user, role, and permission data, initialize a secure data store and authenticate users, and I'll demonstrate how to authorize CRUD operations and modify data based on user access rights. With that, let's get started. First things first, a quick review of the architecture of this API. The API itself consists of three primary parts. The first is the Authentication API, which validates user login and access. The second is the Authorization API, which helps check access rights to different resources, business objects, or database operations via predefined roles. The third is our ORM-specific API. As I've already mentioned, this security API can be used with either Microsoft Entity Framework or DevExpress XPO ORM libraries. I'll put a link in the description for those who wish to compare our ORM to that of Microsoft. Okay, XAF Security API can be used in any .NET application, be it a client app or a server-side solution. This means you can use our API within ASP.NET Core, Blazor, MVC, WebForms, WinForms, WPF, Xamarin, etc. Let's now look at the nuts and bolts of XAF Security API, and I'll show you how quickly you can integrate its capabilities into a new or existing .NET application. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to be using a console application to demonstrate the three required integration steps. Of course, you'll need to add the necessary NuGet packages first. If you haven't done so yet, please refer to this video's description for links. In this example, we're using Entity Framework Core, so I've installed the devexpress.expressapp.efcore package via the DevExpress NuGet feed. This package contains all required assemblies. They are cross-platform, so this package can be used in any .NET Core application. Another important requirement before you proceed with integration is to construct your data model. For Entity Framework, you should have prepared the necessary data context and defined appropriate entities such as employees, departments, etc. You also need to add permission policy role and permission policy user to your entities. These entities are often defined in a class library. The final prerequisite is to generate initial data. This includes user role and permission information. To do this, you'll need to create instances of permission policy user and permission policy role. As you might expect, you'll also need to define necessary permissions. For example, to allow read access to employee data and prevent access to department information via a set of predefined criteria. This particular project creates a database with required tables. Okay, time to get back to the console application and talk about the three integration steps. Number one, we need to initialize XAF security system components. This includes authentication standard and security strategy complex classes. These help set the user and role types used within our application. In this particular demo, we're using built-in classes, but you can use custom classes as needed. To create custom classes, you simply need to implement the appropriate interfaces and use our implementation as your reference. Okay, next you'll need to create a secured object space provider. This provider takes your DB context and your connection information. In this console application, we're using connection string to a SQL Server database. As you can see, it's just a local database. The second step involves user authentication. We need to process both user and password information. You're free to use any custom authentication method. You are not restricted to username and password combinations. For instance, custom authentication methods like OAuth are fully supported. The final step involves user authorization. Once a user logs in, you can create object space data context using the secured object space provider configured earlier. As you can see here, you can call methods to manipulate data as needed. In this demo, users can't read protected permission policy role entities as permissions have not been granted. Our code loads employee records and determines whether the current user has read access to department records. The canRead method is being used here, but lots of other methods exist, including canWrite, canDelete, etc. Based on permission data, you can now determine what to do with your information. For instance, in this example, the user does not have permission to read department info for certain employee records. The employee's department property will return null. We can mask this empty data with protected content placeholders in the UI, console output in our case. When we no longer want to execute secured operations under the current user, we can call the logoff method. Let's run our console application and see how it works. For this, press F5 and wait for the output in the open console. It should show us a list of employees where protected content text is displayed for inaccessible departments. Let's also check out database. We have an EF Core Test DB database, and it contains required XAF security system tables like permission policy user, role, which we discussed earlier. You can also see the tables where permission information is stored. It's interesting that you can edit this information, and our application will react to these changes so that permission checks are fully dynamic. For example, we'll change the criteria to read department information only if department's title contains sale. Now return to our console application and rerun it. Now the console outputs only sale departments and masks the rest of the departments. All these permissions are stored in the database by default, and thus it's possible to change this data at runtime like we demonstrated earlier. These features are favorites among XAF developers because it allows teams to deploy their apps in production and customize the app without the need for redeployment. We demonstrated the simplest case with a console application and permission editing in code or the database. In XAF's WinForms, we built a custom UI to configure permission information by application users. You can modify type permissions. For type permissions, you can configure member or object permissions using specific criteria. We also have a Blazor UI with similar functions. To repeat, this is a very popular feature, as it can save time on modification and deployment of your application. Security configuration functions can be delegated to your end users like administrators or power users. With that, I hope you've enjoyed this introductory video on XAF's user authentication and group authorization API. I'll definitely share more information on this product in the coming months. In the meantime, if you like this video, please give us a thumbs up or post comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel and ring the bell for more great DevExpress videos. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.